Wow. That blew my mind. What's the difference?
Adam, how could you say that? One job forever? That's an insane choice to have to make.
Well, I'm relieved. Now we only have to make one decision in life.
But Adam, how could they have never told us that?
Barry, why would you question anything? We're bees.
We're the most perfectly functional society on Earth.
Hey!
Yeah, but Adam, did you ever think maybe things work a little too well around here?
Like what? Give me one example.
I don't know, but you know what I'm talking about. Wait a second, check it out. Hey, hey, those are pollen jocks!
Wow.
I've never seen them this close.
They know what it's like to go outside the hive.
Yeah, but some of them don't come back.
Oh, hey, Joss!
Guys did great! You're monsters, you're sky freaks, I love it! I love it!
I wonder where those guys have just been.
I don't know.
Their day's not planned. Outside the hive, going who knows where, doing who knows what.
You can't just decide one day to be a pollen junk. You have to be bred for that.
Right.
Look at that. That's more pollen than you and I will see in a lifetime.
That's just a status symbol. I think bees make too big a deal out of it.
Perhaps. Unless you're wearing it, and the ladies see you wearing it.
Those ladies?
Ooh, aren't they our cousins too?
Distant, distant.
Look at these two.
Couple of hive Harrys.
Let's have some fun with them.
It must be so dangerous being a pollen jock.
Oh yeah. One time a bear had me pinned up against a mushroom. He had one paw on my throat, and with the other, he was slapping me back and forth across the face.
Oh my.
I never thought I'd knock him out.
What were you doing during all of this?
Obviously, I was trying to alert the authorities.
I could autograph that if you want.
Little gusty out there today, wasn't it, comrades?
Yeah, gusty. You know, we're gonna hit a sunflower patch around 6 miles from here tomorrow.
6 miles, huh?
Barry!
It's a puddle jump for us, but maybe you're not up for it.
Maybe I am.
You are not. We're going 0900 to J-Gate.
Whoa.
What do you think, Buzzy Boy? Are ya bee enough?
I might be. It all depends on what 0900 means.
Honix!
Oh, Dad, you surprised me.
Ha ha ha.
Have you decided what you're interested in, son?
Well, there's a lot of choices.
But you only get one.
Dad, do you ever get bored of doing the same job every day?
Son, let me tell you something about stirring. You grab that stick and you just move it around. You stir it around. You get yourself into a rhythm. It's a beautiful thing.
You know, Dad, the more I think about it, maybe the honey field just isn't right for me.
And you were thinking of what? Making balloon animals? That's a bad job for a guy with a stinger.
Well, no.
Janet! Your son's not sure. He wants to go into honey.
Oh, Barry, you are so funny sometimes.
I'm not trying to be funny.
You're not funny. You're going into honey. Our son, the stirrer.
You're gonna be a stirrer?
No one's listening to me.
Wait till you see the sticks I have for you.
I can say anything I want right now. I'm gonna get an ant tattoo.
Let's open some fresh honey and celebrate.
I'm gonna pierce my thorax.
To honey.
Shave my antenna.
Honey.
Shack up with a grasshopper and get a gold tooth. And start calling everyone dog.
So proud.